basal metabolic rate, calories, what are they basically? So guys, this video is all about the amount of calories you need in a day. So guys, watch till the end. What's up guys, my name is Saurav Singh. Welcome back to Target Aesthetics. Aesthetic mean beauty, and the motto of my channel is to bring up the best version of yourself, whether it be fitness, whether it be lifestyle, or be it nutrition. So basically, basal metabolic rate is the amount of calories which your body needs per day while at rest. Rest implies that your body needs some amount of energy for blinking eye, let's say for brain functioning, for respiration. So these all energy are required in a day in order to survive. So basal metabolic rate implies those calories, and afterwards you need more energy for suppose you are doing exercise, suppose you are dancing, suppose you are cooking. So those all kind of things requires extra additional energy. And so first we will calculate about basal metabolic rate. We'll actually know what actually calories are required for a body while at rest, and then we will multiply it with a multiplier in order to get our required lifestyle calories, what we need. So guys, basically BMR is calculated according to Mifflin-Senth-Hero equation, but various other websites also can give you BMR, and the multiplier which they give, I find it faulty because I have used it in various clients and I find it that it doesn't work well, right? So what I've come up with multiplier which works well, and after experimenting in different kinds of body, I found out that it was appropriate, and that's what you should follow for the time being. You should experiment in your body, right? So guys, basically first I will be teaching you how to calculate your actually BMR, and then how you should multiply it with your multiplier.
So you can do the following steps. I have given a link in the description box. Kindly open that link and you will be redirected to this page. So you can type as per metric units or US units depending on the information you have. So I am using these units. So I don't know my weights in pounds, right? So I will calculate it. Kg to pound conversion. And let's check it out. 1 kg is 2.2 pounds. My weight is 60 right now. So 132 pounds. That's all. Again, I will go back. And now what I will do is simply 132 pounds in that. And BMR, right? BMR, because different websites for different activity will give you different output. So BMR, so that's what I get it. I got 1511 calories per day, right? So that's what my calories are.
Now family, let's use the multiplier. So as per the multiplier, if you are leading a sedentary lifestyle, that means that you are not doing workout and you are only doing your office work, or your only job is to do your normal work and that's all, you're not doing exercise, so that person must multiply the BMR which we got into 1.1. those person who are leading a moderately active lifestyle, they are doing workouts of 1 to 3 times per week, right? So they should use a multiplier of 1.2. and those guys who are active guys who are doing 3 to 5 days of intense workouts in a week, they should use the multiplier 1.35. they should multiply that BMR with 1.35 in order to get the outcome, the required calories they burn in a day. And those guys who are doing 5 days intense workout, they should use 1.5 as their multiplier. And for those guys who are very active and they work in construction site and also they do some mechanical jobs and workouts, so for them I would recommend 1.65 multiplier. That's what is the multiplier they should multiply with their actual BMR, right? So while taking mine as an example, I should multiply that with 1.5. so as you can see, I got my BMR and now I'm multiplying it with 1.5, and see, I got the result. And this is my maintenance calories. What is maintenance calories? If you don't want to lose weight or don't want to gain weight, you should undertake your maintenance calorie, which is a must if you want to let your weight remain the same. Now coming back to the fat loss muscle gain criteria, I have already discussed the calories and the calorie balances in my previous video. If you have not watched, you are free to click on I button and watch it. Let's say someone gets 2300 calories, which he should consume after multiplying the BMR, which he got with the multiplier, and he got 2300 calories, let's say, suppose. So that means that in order to maintain weight, he should intake 2300 calories. And if he wants to gain weight, then he should intake a surplus of calories. That means maybe 2500 calories or 2600 calories. It depends. And you should consult a doctor or even a personal trainer or a trainer in the gym before going through a too much surplus or too much deficit. But it has been found in and experimented that if you are going in a surplus diet over a particular period of time and you are following that, then you will definitely gain weight. And if you are maintaining calorie deficit, that means that your required calories after multiplying the multiplier with BMR, suppose 2300, and you are intaking 1800 to 1900 calories a day, so that means that you will start losing weight at a constant interval. That depends. And even the macronutrients are also important. So basically, the part of macronutrients, I'll be discussing it in my next video. And guys, believe me, within 5 to 6 months, you guys will prepare your own diet plan according to the meals you like, even the junk food you will include after every 2 to 3 days, right? So guys, stay tuned, many more to come. And do not forget to subscribe my channel and press the bell notification icon so that you do not miss any regular updates from my channel, where I will be uploading some crazy, efficient, effective, smart tips and tricks about fitness, lifestyle, nutrition, and even the workouts too. So guys, see you next time. Till then, take care.